Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss about mass moment of inertia of a uniform rod or slender rod when axis at the end of the rod. See here, slender rod means the diameter is negligible. So we have only length, not a diameter. So in this figure you can observe this is the length of the rod, that is negligible diameter d is equal to 0, and it having a distance. I am going to take an element of thickness dx with a distance of x. If you take a small element, then we can find the moment of inertia for the small element. Definitely, if you integrate with respect to limits 0 to capital L. So we are going to take the limits from 0 to capital L. You will get mass moment of inertia of the total rod. Right? So now, mass of the element, mass of the element, that is equal to dm is equal to m dx, where m is equal to unit mass, that means mass per length, actual mass per length. Small m is equal to capital M by L. So capital M is nothing but total mass, small m into L. So you can prove very easily, you can prove similar. See, very simple. If you integrate dm, you will get total mass m, that is equal to integral m dx. So limits are 0 to capital L. So m is equal to, if you integrate, you will get x of the limits 0 to capital L, that is m into L. See, hence prove. So capital M is equal to small m into L. Remember, this is very important during the derivation. Right? Now, general formula for mass moment of inertia. So, mass moment of inertia about y-axis, that is I is equal to integral x square dm. This is a general formula where x square is equal to perpendicular distance of the element and the square of the single. If you multiply x dm, that is moment. If you multiply x square dm, that is double moment, that is second moment, that is moment of inertia, where dm is the mass of the element. X square, what is dm? Dm is nothing but x into dm, sorry, m into dx. So x, in x direction we have limits 0 to capital L. Then I is equal to, so m is a constant, just keep it outside. So if you integrate x square, you will get x cube by 3 under limits 0 to L. So moment of inertia I is equal to m L cube by 3. So we know that small m into capital L is equal to capital M, total mass of the moment. So I is equal to m into capital L into L square by 3. So you can write, so instead of small m into L, you can substitute capital M. So I is equal to m L square by 3. So this is the formula for mass moment of inertia.